So who cares? You wanna know why? You wanna know why? Brook is an 89-year-old man with a hockey.
Beats on his daughter.
But it's mainly because of what he did. And I feel some type of way about this, but my fraud is monkey.
Who's your fraud? My fraud is actually...
Welcome to Fraud Court. Nobody's favorite character is safe. We putting your character on trial for fraudulence. This episode, the first installment of Fraud Court, we got One Piece characters. And you know they ain't safe from fraudulence. Now it's time to see who's guilty or who makes it off scot-free and is innocent.
This man is powerful.
All right.
Part of the worst generation.
All right.
Let's let him cook.
A very skilled fighter.
Okay.
But if he wasn't such a pussy with his devil fruit, law would be so much better.
Oh, oh, so oh my God.
No.
Now see, I think I can hear from unanimous.
No.
The crowd is saying law is not a fraud.
Get me out. Y'all ready? Because we in the kitchen and I'm about to cook. Present your evidence.
So Pete Gang, and don't get me wrong.
Yeah, why is
I still love law.
Mm-hmm.
That's my dog. But I can tell my friends you being a little bitch. Get strong. And law,
man, yeah.
With his devil fruit and abilities, should lose very few fights.
Yeah.
Okay.
Law should not be out here getting smacked around like he does.
Okay,
and I'm not talking about big people like Kaido and Big Mom. Law is struggling with folks that he shouldn't have been struggling with.
Okay.
I don't care.
You might have a point.
Doflamingo should not have been handling Law like that.
All right.
Law, no. Listen, Law fighting Doflamingo is the same Law fighting Big Mom. He does
have the eye of the tiger. Are you sure about that?
What? He might be cooking. He might be cooking, bro.
All right, everybody. We heard what he said. Now let's get. Do you think Law should be guilty? If you think he should be guilty, make noise right now. If you think he's not guilty, make some noise.
All right, that's my point past the protest.
Y'all might not like this tape, but
it's okay, that's what fraud
was. Who's your fraud?
My fraud is actually Robin.
Hey, it's powerful niggardry at work here.
She started to fall the fuck off, no fighting, none of that. It was just, you get what I'm saying? She was just progressing her strength. We just found out who her fruit was and Wano. Why we just finding out she got a 5-5 fruit and Wano?
That is not correct.
It should be way before that. You get what I'm saying? I felt like she should have displayed her skills a lot more until she got to Ryan. And then not only that, she was in the Revolutionary Army. I feel like she should have had way, she should have busted the whole.
Alright, if y'all agree with the brother, we'll make some noise. If y'all don't, let's make some noise.
My girl Robin is clear of the fraud allegations.
Well, duh.
I lose you fraud, brother. But in my opinion, Big Mom is a huge fraud. First off,
let's hear him out.
First off, she was. How many attacks she gave kids? Like time after time after time. I'm not gonna do those spoilers, but somebody else just chopped him down like he wasn't nothing.
Hey, that's fair.
She really used any conference hockey in the fight against Kid Law.
You might be good.
Unless she's supposed to have that or something. I don't know, I guess.
That's fair.
I'm not a Big Mom fan, so I'm letting you have this one. I want to see what everybody else say too.
I ain't gonna lie, Robin and Big Mom face like this back to back.
So misogyny. If y'all agree with it, if Big Mom's a fraud, let's hear it. All right. If Big Mom's not a fraud, let's hear it.
Woo!
I think we got our first fraud.
Get it out of here. She's
I think y'all know.
Who's your fraud?
He's part of the worst generation. Useless Captain Mid. Yeah. Useless Mid. Captain Kid. Let me start.
I was waiting for it.
Cook.
And Wano, this nigga didn't do shit on the rooftop. He didn't do a goddamn thing, bro. His vice captain looked better than him. That nigga took more damage than him. That nigga did more damage than him. And then in the Big Mom fight, Law carried him. Big Mom broke her bones. That bitch got up and said, "Damn, Chomp like a Law's techniques are dangerous." And that was right after Kid attacked her. It even got to the point where Law was like, "Bro, why the fuck you keep attacking after me? Like, every time I attack, you gotta attack. Why the fuck you keep attacking after me?" And then I'm not gonna spoil nothing for the manga, but he got babied by somebody. I ain't gonna say shit. He got, also, his belt through his ass. His belt through his ass, too, bro.
Voice a little hoarse, bear with me. Yeah, y'all, let him cook.
If you love One Piece, can I just get up, one time?
Yes, sir!
I'm gonna go with Kaido, man.
Yes!
Fraud. Kaido's a fraud?
He's a fraud. I could cook.
Let him cook.
Look, my voice not big, so let me cook. I got three good points. For one, Mihawk, they say he's the strongest swordsman. It's not bet on Mihawk, he's the strongest swordsman. Whitebeard, strongest pirate, and strongest man after Roger. You get the context. But with Kaido, we get him losing. He's been arrested a few times. Yeah, he was hungry. He took seven L's. He's so-called the king of the beast, strongest creature, all that shit. Right? Beats on his daughter.
And messed his house.
Nigga, did I just catch you having fun?
He went to Marineford, and Shanks said, "Turn that ass around."
Oh my god.
I don't know how y'all coming in, but he got the smile fruits. Come on, fake devil fruits? That's literally fraudulent shit. What the fuck are we talking about? Come
on, he might be cooking. He might be on something.
Trap
Lord Kaido might be a fraud.
He cook? Are we eating? Is Kaido a fraud?
Damn.
This one is a hot-ass take, I ain't gonna lie to you. And I'm gonna say this not because of his power, all right? but it's mainly because of what he did. And I feel some type of way about this, but my fraud is Monkey D. Garp. My fraud is Monkey D. Garp. And here's my explanation for that.
Zoro's dream is to be the greatest swordsman that you know, ever. Yeah. What is Dracula? The greatest swordsman ever right now. So do you think that Zoro fighting Dracula Mihawk would be his strongest appointment? No. Zoro, that's just a stepping stone that Zoro needs to achieve first as a character to full complete. But then he also needs to, you know, obviously fight some stronger opponents. I'm not saying Dracula is obviously, you know, not strong. He's obviously strong. But everyone's like, Shanks or Dracula? Shanks or Mihawk? No.
I can't believe we're doing this right now. I can't believe we're having this conversation right now.
Wow.
I got to hear what y'all think on this one, bro.
So, all right, we're going to see. Is Mihawk a fraud? Let's hear it.
That one,
don't say nothing.
So Mihawk's out for us. That's what you see. Come on.
resources.
Straight like that. He'll be the number one person in the show. Above the streets.
Oh, ho, brother. Ho, whoa, whoa, whoa. Now, you got too much dip on your chip.
Oh, wait.
Whoa, hey.
Killer, I agree with you. Killer is that guy, Killer will do it to you. They don't call me Killer for no reason.
I think everybody agree with your point, but just not your reason. So he could be a fraud.
Alright, so, my biggest fraud, that bitch ass clown Boogie, bro.
I'm like, what did he say fuck me for?
Buggy?
Yes, sir, Clown Buggy. Yes.
Chop Chop Buggy?
Chop Chop Buggy.
Debatably the next Pirate King?
That's a fucking fraud. That's what they're talking, right?
Hey,
let him cook, y'all. Alright, so, come here. Hey, Impel Valley. Right, one of the said, so we heard Buggy is in the ship. He helping y'all try to get to Ace, right? So why this bitch ass there just saying impale down and saying, oh, let that help Luffy with this bullshit. Cause the bullshit should stay there and the Marines should never know.
Buggy
D. Clone,
my guy.
Hey, I will say, if Buggy's a fraud, Buggy might be one of the biggest frauds in One Piece. He might be the most successful fraud. Cause like,
he's got a point.
He does being a fraud right?
Yeah,
we want to say thank you to everybody who came out, man. We really, really appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
And that's going to do it for the first episode of Fraud Court. Some got away with their freedom, and others got sent to level 6 Impel Down. But it's up to you, the viewer, to decide the fate of the situation of Porkus D. Ace and Garp, the hero. Will they get off innocent? Or will they be guilty of their fraudulence? If you want to report any fraudulent activity being had, contact us on Twitter at Bros Who Think, Chrissa SJE, Real Jazzy Boy, and lynbwt. It's up to us to keep these frauds off the street. But until next time, peace.